Good evening. It's working. Good evening. It's lovely to see so many people here. I'm Caroline Heslop, the Artistic Director of NW Live Arts, and it's our pleasure to welcome you here this evening for our concert, Belonging. In this concert, you're going to hear a mixture of words and music, words written by poets who've been writing for the last 6 weeks in our workshop, facilitated by John Simmons of 26, Bloomsbury-based writers' organisation, and music that's been rehearsed by our four musicians. I just want to say that it is so nice to see so many people again after the past year. It's wonderful to connect and belong, and also to collaborate. And this festival seems to me it's all about collaboration. So this evening you're going to hear poems and music on the themes, two themes. The theme of the festival, Shining Light, and the theme that we have worked on, Belonging. I'm going to introduce the first set. We're going to have words spoken by the commissioning editor for Bloomsbury Radio, Cal Courtney, on a theme of belonging. And then you're going to hear three pieces of music. We'd like to segue the whole of this first set, so if you can resist applauding until the end of the third piece of music, that would be lovely. The poets, as I mentioned, have been working for 6 weeks. They are drawn from communities at Hope and Community Association and Birkbeck University Star students. It's been an absolute pleasure working with all of them. Thank you very much. I'd now like to welcome the musicians to the stage. Please. Christina McMaster. Toby Carr. Attab Haddad. Antonio Romero. And Cal Courtney is coming up as soon as I've calmed down. Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline. What, I don't get an applause? good evening, everybody. And I'd like to extend my gratitude to NW Live Arts for their invitation to come and share some words from the Irish writer John O'Donoghue to start off the performance this evening. I met John probably 35 years ago in the city of Galway in the west of Ireland. And at the time, John was a Catholic priest. He was not famous. He was not the international famous writer he was later to become through his two main books, Adam Cara and Eternal Echoes. But he was a man of great profundity and compassion. Awkward in build, but extremely accommodating and welcoming to everybody who came his way. And when John died in early January 2008, his family, his friends, and his readers were, of course, distraught because what was a very important and inclusive voice seemed lost. But in the midst of that bereavement, a really profound sense of consolation began to emerge and was shared and recorded by his friends, his family, and his readers around the world. And that consolation came from the very same source that John O'Donoghue drew from. John, more than anyone I have ever come across, showed courage in entering into his own vulnerability. And with that courage, and with that journey into his own vulnerability, he discovered a sense of belonging which is there for all of us. No matter what the stress, no matter what the alienation, no matter what the depression we may be feeling, a sense of belonging that echoes as an existential state in every human heart. And these words from his book, Eternal Echoes, sum up very much what he has to say. The hunger to belong is at the heart of our nature. Cut off from others, we turn in on ourselves. The sense of belonging is the natural balance of our lives. Mostly, we do not need to make an issue of belonging. When we belong, we take it for granted. But there is some innocent, childlike side to the human heart that is always deeply hurt when we are excluded. Belonging suggests warmth, understanding, and embrace. No one was created for isolation. When we become isolated, we are prone to being damaged. Our minds lose their flexibility and natural kindness. We become vulnerable to fear and negativity. The sense of belonging keeps you in balance amidst the inner and outer immensities. The ancient and eternal values of human life, truth, unity, goodness, justice, beauty, and love, are all statements of true belonging. They are also the secret intention and dream of every human longing.
Thank you. good evening, everyone. Thank you so much. So I just want to tell you a little bit about the next group of pieces. So there's a sort of strong theme in the sets of poems that you're going to hear. Are firstly a collection, Beginning I Am, and then these were written by Onyema, Jocelyn, Verin, and Ola. Verin can't be here, so Gareth is going to read for him. And then after that, you're going to hear the Shining Light poems, which is the theme of the festival, as you know. And these are going to be read by Janet, Jocelyn, Gareth, and Betty. And the music that you're going to hear following this has got lots of Spanish and French vibes and a bit of Italian as well. We were speaking earlier about Scarlatti, who actually originally from Naples, he actually identified more as a Spanish and a Spaniard, and you can hear that in his music. So that's a lovely little music box somewhere. It's very nice. So that's what you're going to hear following these poems. A couple of pieces. Toby, you're playing a piece by Robert de Vise, is that right? 17th century French composer. And alongside that, you're going to hear some Eric Satie. And we've actually kind of livened up a very well-known piece by Eric Satie, the Gymnopédie No. 1. And you'll hear it in an unusual way, a familiar piece in an unusual way. And to complete the set, which has a very sort of light and energetic feel, and also kind of conversational, you'll hear that between the hands, especially in the Scarlatti, and then also in the Debussy, it's just full of joy and abandonment. And he actually writes those words at the top of the score of the music. So firstly, you're going to hear an étude pour les octaves, and then after that, an étude pour les huit doigts. And you may even continue to hear the lovely music box. So this is our next group of pieces.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Onyema, and I'm going to read you a poem on I Am. I am from a kingdom. I am a wonder. I am a genius. I am an unstoppable. I am the light. I am brave. I am brilliant. I am on a winning journey. I am good.
I am from stress and calm. I'm from anger and suppression. I'm from curiosity and cold. I'm from the flat fenland, open skies, peaceful meadows with cows. I'm from sooty trains, grit in your eye, chilblains on bare knees.
This is by Viren Patel. I am from India. I am from London. I am from a loving family. I am from a diverse pool of cultures. I am from the East and the West. I am from the Hindu scriptures and the Bible. I am from the product of my friends, neighbors, and acquaintances. I am from the imagination of my ancestors.
Good evening. I'm Ola. I am from Lagos, the former capital and the most populous city in Nigeria. It was fun growing up in this city, with its variety of tribes and culture, living together as one. Orilede Nigeria ni motiwa, ilu Eko ni motiwa. Thank you.
Suddenly, I see an anguished woman on her knees before me. I want to reach out to her, but I am only a candle. My purpose is to light the space around me, flicker and die. Now I see this woman getting up. She crosses herself, saying something I can't hear. It's not my business to listen. This corner is where secrets are hid. But now she's saying more and more, louder and louder. This is a church, a silent place, a place for prayer and meditation. Then someone comes and takes her by the hand and walks her to the door. My job has been done. I flicker and go out.
This is by Viren Patel. I am a dim light, a diminutive object, sitting unobtrusively, apparently to one side of the room. Yet I draw furtive glances, occasional stares, hidden peaks from those around me. My micro stature belies the inordinate power and control I have over people. Continuous low level of light, intermittent flashes of activity on my screen light the room for a second. Warnings, news, chats, bringing the outside world into this space.
I am a slender handheld candle. I'm very bright out there. Is obscure, dense, dark, and scary. Tiny flames make halos round our faces. They glow, and the dark softly wraps round us.
I am the moon, controlling, shaping the sea. Can you see me? I can be pregnant, yellow, half, crescent, and full.
Thank you.
apples falling from the tree must create a rhythm of sorts. Apples falling from the tree must create a rhythm of sorts.
Beautiful music stirs and lifts the soul. Beautiful music stirs and lifts the soul.
The combination of the musical lines and the rhythm makes me one with the music. Combination of the musical lines and the rhythm make me one with the music.
Delight in the sound streaming lightly across the room. Delight in the sound streaming lightly across the room. Delight in the sounds.
Thank you. Fourth set begins with Zen poems spoken by Betty. These were written by the whole group, so no single author. And these are followed by two sunset poems read by Gareth and Ola. Our final set of music starts off exploring the connections between lute and the oud. I've got here a Renaissance lute, which had its heyday really in the 16th century, and then a theorbo, giant bass lute with extra bass strings, and a Baroque guitar, which really had their high point in the 17th century. But if you want to start chronologically, you really start with the oud. So I'll hand over to Attab to say something about his instrument.
So the oud is actually the ancestor of a lot of European plucked strings, including the theorbo and the lute, I would have thought. So the oud came back to Europe with the Crusaders. The oud and the lute, well, once it came to Europe, they added frets to it, and as the instrument evolved, it became the lute. So, etymologically, the word oud and laoud became lute, so it's actually the same instrument, but it was modified once it came to Europe. So, a bit about the program. We needed to find something that we could do in common, and we thought Spanish was sort of the link between us. Musically speaking. So we're going to perform a piece by Manuel de Falla, which is my own arrangement called La Tarara, and then we're doing a piece by Santiago de Murcia, followed by my own composition, Longueuil.
Zen poems. Listening to the rain on leaves, seeing the branches hanging low. Rain from the tree splashes on the ground. Drip, drop, drip, drop, the old man sighs. Picking up a handful of sand could make my nails dirty. It's slipping through fingers. Orange, golden grains, beautiful colors in a handful of sand.
London Sunset by Viren Patel. A burning sphere reluctantly sinking at the end of a long day. A spectrum from amber to red, gilding the Portland stone. The receding river shimmering as it reveals a beach hitherto unknown. glowing shards of steel and glass cut into the warm blue sky. Laughter and voices in a host of languages and nations multiply. Diverse music and spoken word in an impromptu congregation, at the same time discordant yet harmonious, a uniting of nations. A warm breeze carries me home, evocative and energizing. Memories of family, friends, and acquaintances from workplaces. Buildings and histories, people, culture, sharing the same spaces.
A cool sunset. The bright sunshine begins to dim after a warm day. The shadows of images fading slowly. The canoes from the lagoon moving towards the bank. The glowing tongues of fire coming from the kerosene lamp. Laughter and shouts are consumed into the light. At the same time, casting shadows of each word spoken. The cool breeze of the night calming the day's tension. Families, friends, and acquaintances blend into a smile.
Thank you. Thank you.